Let us please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Blanche died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Blanche, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of God's word.
words of wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away is not an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before men, indeed they be punished, yet it is hope full of immortality. Cast eyes a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them, and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand the truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for the living God. When shall I see him face to face?
My soul is thirsting for the living God. When shall I see him face to face?
As the hind longs for running waters, so my soul longs for you, O God.
My soul is thirsting for the living God. When shall I see him face to face?
A thirst is my soul for God, the living God. When shall I go and behold the face of God? Send forth your light and your fidelity. They shall lead me on and bring me to your holy mountain, to your dwelling place. Then will I go in the altar of God, the God of my gladness and joy. Then will I give you thanks upon the heart, O God, my God.
My soul is thirsty for the living God. When shall I see him?
Why are you so downcast, O my soul? Why do you sigh within me? Hope in God, for I shall again be thanking him in the presence of my Savior and my God. First letter of John. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for ye shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us stand. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Mary came to where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said to him, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come with her weeping, he became perturbed and deeply troubled, and said, Where have you laid him? They said to him, Sir, come and see. And Jesus wept. So the Jews said, See how he loved him. But some of them said, Could not the one who opened the eyes of the blind man have done something so that this man would not have died? So Jesus, perturbed again, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone lay across it. Jesus said, Take away the stone. Martha, the dead man's sister, said to him, Lord, by now there will be a stench. He has been dead for 4 days. Jesus said to her, Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? So they took away the stone, and Jesus raised his eyes and said, Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me, but because of the crowd, here I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me. And when he had said this, he cried out in a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. The dead man came out, tied hand and foot with burial bands, and his face was wrapped in a cloth. So Jesus said to them, Untie him and let him go. Now many of the Jews who had come to Mary and seen what he had done began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. On behalf of Father Christensen, the pastor here of St. Anthony's Parish, I want to welcome you all and are grateful for your presence, especially on behalf of the Bernadt and Conradt and Trompeter families. Thank you for your presence here, and thank you for those who are uniting with us in heart and in prayer today through the media and technology. Today, we hear Jesus pray to his Father at the tomb of Lazarus. Father, I thank you for hearing me. I know that you always hear me. But because of the crowd here, I have said this, that they may believe that you sent me. The Father hears the Son. The Son trusts in his Father. And he communicates that to Martha and Mary. He tells Martha, Did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? This is the faith we have received, the faith that we celebrate today. For if we believe, we will see the glory of God. And we know that Blanche believed. She received this faith here in St. Anthony's in Steinauer, Nebraska. She received this gift of faith from her parents, Joseph and Mary, her godmother and sister, Sister Mary Birchman's, the Benedictines, and those who helped communicate the faith to her at St. Anthony's grade school. And St. Benedict and St. Scholastica, you know, they were brother and sister. St. Benedict, he begins his rule of life with, listen with the ear of the heart. Listen with the ear of the heart. Blanche learned to do that at a young age and throughout her life, to listen with the ear of her heart, to listen in faith. And what did St. Scholastica witness to? A life of prayer. St. Scholastica, who tells her brother, I asked my God and he heard my prayer. And isn't that what we see in the gospel today? Jesus praying to his Father, knowing that his Father is listening. What we see the Blessed Virgin Mary witnessing at the Annunciation and at the foot of the cross, trusting in God, even in the midst of her son's death. And this Saturday is a day we honor the Blessed Mother every Saturday, and we really unite with her in her waiting in faith, her waiting in prayer, in faith, and trust in the Father's goodness, in his love, that he is faithful to his promises. And that was the witness that you experienced with your mother. Oh, her prayerfulness, her waiting, trusting in the Father's love. Oh, this faith of Saint Scholastica, I asked my God and he heard my prayer. She lived this faith in love. The beautiful vocation of marriage. First to Leonard, her ace, for 8 years. And then Joe for 48 years. The beautiful vocation of marriage, living the faith in love, sharing that faith with one another and also with their children. Robert, Jerry, Ed, Marty, Ann, and Tommy. Sharing that faith, the children witnessed their parents' love. They witnessed this faith in Blanche. It was in her kindness, in her charity, in her patience, in her smile, in her voice. The fruits of the Spirit, huh? The fruits of love, joy, gentleness, patience. Those are the fruits of a life lived in faith. The fruits of the Spirit. And so beautiful to see her journey, huh? She, from Nebraska to Washington, D.C., to San Francisco, and her work as a stenographer. Shouldn't underestimate the importance of that work. And we are grateful for her work and service. and then her work at Campbell's Soup. And I imagine the same witness that you experienced at home, she gave in the workplace. The witness that Father McGuire and I had a chance to see as we would visit her, oftentimes on First Fridays. She was always expecting our visit on First Friday to receive the Eucharist, the gift of Jesus himself. And I recounted last night, you know, my memory of her is listening and hearing her voice telling me to come in the door, and then usually Spirit Catholic Radio was on, or it was coming in just barely. We were right on the edge of tuning in to Spirit Catholic Radio, but what a great example. Just the hour by hour prayerfulness. And she prayed for you. She prayed for all of us. And she would ask us, you know, as we would ask for her prayer, she said, I will pray for you as long as you pray for me. And so we do today. We lift up her soul to Almighty God in thanksgiving for her witness, her example of a kind heart, generous soul. We hear in the readings today from the letter of St. John, his first letter. See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. Blanche kept that childlike spirit, that faith in God, that we do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him. We shall be like our God, for we shall see him as he is. We pray that she is seeing him as he is in the eternal glory, the beatific vision, the reality of heaven. And in the psalm today, Psalm 42, it says, my soul is thirsting for the living God. When shall I see him face to face? And Jesus says in the gospel today, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? This is the answer to that desire, that prayer of the psalmist in Psalm 42. It's the answer to prayer. I asked my God, and he heard my prayer. They who are friends of Jesus, those who believe in him as Savior, death does not have the final word. Those who believe in him will see his glory. And so we pray today that Blanche is experiencing this beatific vision, this perpetual and divine light of heaven, for she believed. And we pray that she may sing of his love and his mercy for all eternity, as we hear in the psalm. Then will I go to the altar of God, the God of my gladness and joy. Hope in God, for I shall again be thanking him in the presence of my Savior and my God. Blanche, as we pray for you today, we ask you to please pray for us. Pray that our faith, hope, and charity continue to grow so that we might all realize this prayer of Jesus being heard by his Father and Jesus telling us, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer, that the church may be a comforting witness to Christ, our resurrection and our life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are burdened by their loss may be blessed with courage, strength, and patience. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who mourn the loss of land may be embraced by consolation and peace. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Ace, Joe, Robert, Marty, Ann, and Blanche, all who have died, may be judged in mercy on the last day. And may all of us, the living and the dead, rise in glory. And grace on the great day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in our hearts, united in the Holy Spirit, we pray those of Mary, the Mother of God, our patron, St. Anthony, and all the saints in life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the deceased members of the Bernadt, Conradt, Trompeter family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the presentation of the gifts. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice.
As we humbly present to you these sacred sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Blanche, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return, on account of sin, to the earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we, who have been redeemed by the death of your Son, shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely upon.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth. With your servant Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Blanche, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her with your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Blanche may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Our response is, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Blanche in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Blanche in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.